Patrick House may not be a superhero, but he is this year's biggest success story, having just won the coveted title of NBC's The Biggest Loser. Patrick and his family were in the Cayman Islands visiting his brother Donnie, who is the acting director of the government's internal audit department.
The surgeries and the lap band and the stomach segment should be the absolute last resort. Anyone that's severely overweight that needs help can start by simply just changing their diet, and then you get exercise as you can fit it in and as you can manage it. And you know, early on, it doesn't have to mean you have to go to the gym. I mean, you can do simple things as far as parking in the furthest away parking spot at the grocery store and walking in, taking the stairs instead of the elevator at work. Things like that, to where you can get some exercise in, and if you're changing your diet and you're severely overweight, you're going to lose weight. And once you start seeing the numbers come off and you see the scale start to move, then your motivation increases because you realize you're making a difference and you can see the pounds coming off and your clothes start fitting looser and you start realizing that, hey, I am making a difference and I'm winning, I'm doing this.
His transformation from an unhealthy 400 pounds to a slim and trim 219 pounds isn't the only thing the House family is celebrating. Encouraged by her husband's determination to succeed, Bradley House also decided to get healthy and fit and dropped from a size 14 to a size 4.
You know, you get to this point where you're so depressed about what you look like that you just kind of give up. And it finally just took both of us just kind of being really disgusted with not ever having anything to wear, not ever being happy in the things that we do have to wear, and you know, you don't feel good, but you don't realize that you don't feel good until you start losing the weight, and you're like, wow, I really was not feeling well.
The Houses know what it's like to struggle with weight, and Patrick is urging everyone out there not to give up.
At the same time, I mean, I'm not a superhero by any stretch. Anybody can do this. It's a simple formula of calories in versus calories out, and you know, getting the exercise. So anyone can lose the weight. It's just you gotta start being active and start moving.
He says Cayman is a great place to get fit, and he's hoping that in the future, government officials will take advantage of his newfound celebrity, and they can work together to promote the islands.
It is a shame in my eyes that the Cayman Islands didn't, what I think, take advantage of the opportunity. I mean, I believe the number was 18 million watched the live finale, and then however many million watched the Today Show and live with Bridges and Kelly. It would have been my three outlets for them. But unfortunately, it didn't come to. But hey, I mean, it's like I said, no hard feelings, and I'm here. I'm going to continue to come in here. My brother lives here. We're going to be coming to see the family, and you know, if something in the future comes out of it, fantastic. If not, there's other fish to fry.
To hear more about Patrick's story, check out The Weekender in this Friday's Caymanian Compass and pick up a copy of next Sunday's Observer on Sunday. I'm Norma Connolly, reporting for the Caymanian Compass.